a lot of the money in this bill isn't going to get spent in 2021. It's not going to get spent until 2022. Hundreds of billions of dollars. How can it be that a bill that has so much backloaded spending be designed to address an urgent need?
So if you look at the issues of schools, right, what we've done is we've gone painstakingly through the best estimates from the CDC and other independent areas to say, what is the aggregate resource need to actually get schools open this spring and then into the next year?
You guys are taking a lot of incoming for backsliding on the promise of the first 100 days, you were gonna have kids back in classes. And that seems to be an elusive, a now kind of a goal that's receding in a lot of people's minds. So I guess it does get to, I think, a political and substantive potential vulnerability of the bill.
I'll politely reject the premise of the question in the following sense. Politically.
Thank you for being polite about it. Rejection is fine with me as long as it's polite.
Politically and substantively, there are more schools open today for more children, for more in-person learning than there were a month ago. That's point number one. And so this sense in which somehow we're backsliding, I think, is actually at odds with the facts. The second point is the American Rescue Plan is not a plan to spend out the resources on schools slowly.
Right.
Our critics are suggesting that that money can only be spent out slowly. That's not actually what's in the bill. What's in the bill is to provide the resources for this school year and for the beginning of the next school year. So for the parents out there who are worried about, are these resources going to go to school districts so that they have a better chance of opening for more in-person class over the course of the next couple of months,
right,
the answer is absolutely yes. This is our plan for surging the resources necessary to get the schools open. If you're not going to support that, what is your plan? Because we know and we've seen that when schools actually have these resources, they act and they move and they open.